everyone. Welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, now we will talk individually about root and stem. So in this video, we will talk about the structure of the dicot and the monocot root. So the learning objectives will be to explain the structural features of a dicot and a monocot root in the cross sections. So before we move on to the anatomy of the dicot root, let us first understand that whether we know what is a monocot and dicot or not. I'm pretty sure all of us know that the monocot are the ones which have only single cotyledon, that is the seed leaf. And dicots are the ones which have two cotyledons, that is the two seed leaves are present. We know the function of cotyledon to provide nutrition to the seed. Now, mere seeing we are able to differentiate a monocot and dicot. So visually only we can say, okay, this plant is a monocot and this plant is a dicot, because generally the monocots are herbaceous like maize, sugarcane, and dicots are big trees like neem tree, peepal tree and all of these. So basic organs in which a monocot and dicot differ is the leaf, the stem, the flower and the root. So first we'll take up a root. So let us now discuss anatomy of a dicot root. So the internal structure of dicot root is divided into three zones. The first of which is the epidermis. Epidermis, as we have already discussed in the dermal tissue system, it is made up of thin walled living cells with no intercellular space. In case of root, epidermis is known as epiblema, right? Now, we also know that in case of roots, the cells of the epidermis protrude out to form unicellular root hairs. And as we have discussed in dermal tissue system, the function of root hair is maximum absorption of water and nutrients for the plant. Next layer is cortex. The cortex is made up of several layers of parenchymatous cells. So parenchymatous cells is the feature of cortex. This is further divided into three zones, the first of which is exodermis. In case of exodermis, the cells are suberized, which means that they are 2 to 3 layer thick, and they have a layer of suberin deposited on them. Now, the function is preventing exit of water. So because suberin is a waxy layer, so it prevents exit of water from the cortical layer. Next layer is general cortex layer. General cortex layer made up of only thin walled living parenchymatous cells. And the function is, as the function of the parenchyma cells, storage of food and as well as conduction of water. Now the next layer is endodermis. Endodermis is the innermost layer of cortex. So it is the last layer of the cortex. Beyond it, the steel tissue or the main vascular tissue will start. So this is the innermost layer. It is made up of barrel shaped cells. So barrel shaped cells is the characteristic of endodermis. The shape of the cells is barrel. So it is somewhat like this. There is no intercellular spaces between them. Now the radial and the tangential wall of the endodermis is surrounded with the layer of impermeable waxy substance known as suberin, and the layer is called Casparian strip. So Casparian strips are present in the endodermis of the root. So the radial as well as the tangential walls, they have a thickening of suberin and it is known as Casparian strips. Now because of the Casparian strips, the endodermis is like a watertight jacket. So what is it doing? It is preventing the loss of water from the cortical layers, right? Now there are some cells of endodermis which are right above the protoxylem. So if you see in the diagram, this dark layer is of endodermis, and here you can see just above the protoxylem are the cells which are known as passage cells or transfusion cells. The main feature of these cells is that they do not have Casparian strip. So the entire endodermis has Casparian strips. The cells just above the protoxylem, small cells, do not have Casparian strip. Now since the Casparian strip or the thickening is absent, then what is the function? Radial conduction of water. So passage cells or transfusion cells are present in the layer of endodermis, help in radial conduction. Now the next layer. Next layer is the vascular tissue layer. It is known as steel, which is the central vascular cylinder, with including vascular bundle, pith and pericycle. So this steel is made up of mainly three layers. First is the pericycle. Now pericycle is made up of parenchymatous cells only. So, but these parenchymatous cells are little thick. So they have thick walled parenchymatous cells. Now the function of pericycle in case of root is very important. They show, in case of dicot root, they show active cell division. Now when active cell division means they are meristematic. So they form the vascular cambium. And for vascular cambium, it causes the secondary growth. And another important function of pericycle is initiation of lateral roots. So from the primary root, the lateral roots which arise, it is mainly because of the pericycle, right? Next is the vascular bundles. We all know in case of root, exarch vascular bundles, the xylem is exarch, which means protoxylem is towards periphery and metaxylem is towards center, right? Next is radial, means vascular bundles are arranged alternatively. Now the condition in case of dicot root is tetrarch, means four patches of vascular bundles are present. Clearly you can see in diagram, 1, 2, 3, 4. They are radial, they are exarch, protoxylem is towards outer side, metaxylem is towards the center, right? And the layers of cells surrounding the vascular bundle, they are parenchymatous pericycle, right? The next is pith. Now in case of dicot root, the pith is very small or completely absent. And there are some parenchymatous cells between the vascular bundle. See, this is a phloem, this is a xylem. So layered between, in between the parenchymatous cells are known as conjunctive tissue, right? Conjunctive tissue is also very important characteristic of dicot root. Now next, monocot root. Now the basic features are just the same. There is an epidermis, there is a cortex, pericycle, pith, vascular bundles, all of these are absent. But the major characteristics here is that the vascular bundles are polyarch, mainly hexarch, which means that there are more than four or around six patches of vascular bundles, xylem and phloem, present in them. So the vascular bundles radial, exarch, but polyarch. But pith in this case is large. So there we didn't have pith. Pith was small or absent, but here we have a large pith. Clearly you can see in the diagram, the pith is large. Also we know that the monocots do not undergo secondary growth. That is the reason here pericycle will not undergo active cell divisions. The pericycle will only lead to formation of lateral roots. So to summarize, we can differentiate between dicot and a monocot root. The monocot xylem is polyarch, the xylem is tetrarch in case of dicots. Here the pith is usually large, there the pith is small or completely absent also. Here the metaxylems in case of cross section, they are generally circular, but there in dicot root the metaxylem is polygonal. Next, conjunctive tissue. We learned that in case of dicot root the conjunctive tissue was parenchymatous, but here in monocot the conjunctive tissue is clarenchymatous. Next, all of us know, since there is no secondary growth, so the pericycle is only causing initiation of lateral roots. But in dicot, both secondary xylem and secondary phloem is being formed by pericycle, and also lateral roots are being formed by pericycle. So this was all about the anatomy of dicot and monocot root. In the upcoming video, let us learn about the anatomy of dicot and monocot stem. Till then, thank you.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.